Welcome to Aviation Wings channel. This is your captain Neil J. In this video, I will share with you essential tips and settings to fly at night safely without the hassle and stress. Let's dive in. Flying a drone at night can be a rewarding experience. It allows you to capture a unique cityscapes, starry skies, and light trails. But it also presents unique challenges and risks different than day flying. I won't be covering the legal aspect of night flying, as rules and regulations vary by region. Be sure to research and comply by your local guidelines. Instead, I'm going to give you basic essential safety tips to fly safe at night. I'll be breaking down all tips and details at the end of the video. Make sure you stick around. These tips apply to any DJI drone or FPV drone, such as DJI Avata 1, Avata 2, DJI NEO, flying it with either motion controller or remote controller. There are at least three safety tips you need to consider for night flying. First, GPS signal. Second is drone lighting. And three, launching area lighting. Let's talk about the first one, GPS signal. Literally, the drone uses GPS to level itself. So make sure that you have good GPS signal before you take off. And avoid flying if you have any warning about GPS signal. And if you do have any warning about GPS signal, land as soon as possible. You don't want to be continue flying. You will get a warning message that says ambient light is too weak. That means the drone cannot use its downward ground position visual sensor to navigate reliably. So you need to be aware of that. You need to attach anti-collision strobe light on top of your drone. That flashes about one time per second. And it can be seen about 3 miles away, 5 kilometers away. Choose a launching area with good lighting to help you find your way back to land. Also, because you have light, your ground position visual sensor will work and it will help you land. So make sure you have a good lighting area. For best camera setting, leave auto mode. Let the camera pick the best setting for you. For video quality, 4K 30 is good. 4K 60 if you fly an FPV. Set your maximum ISO to 3200. Color profile, normal. No need for D-log or any flat profile settings. Usually that's good for more like day flying. So right now I have the modern auto, ISO 3200. And so the most important thing, the ISO limit right here. 3200 is the maximum. More than that, you see that light over there, like how bright it is. So if you're looking at that light while you're flying and there is a dark area right next to it, it will be so bright. So I believe 3200 is the best setting as far as the ISO limit, because more than that, it's just gonna make the contrast is huge between the light and the dark. And as you see, the color normal. So those are my settings.
Thank you for helping me hit 2,000 watched hours. This milestone fuels my passion to bring you more content. Thank you very much. Also, special thanks for DeepSeek, the new advanced AI, for helping me refine the key point of this video. Now, without further ado, buckle up and let's get up in the air. All right, GPS is full signal. Let's go ahead and start the engines. Show you the light. All right, so Flying here shouldn't be an issue because we have plenty of flights. As you see, we're climbing up. I'm gonna go to 200 feet. Go a little bit faster in the sport mode. So when there are no lights, like right here, down here, as you see, it's really dark. There's some homes here. In this park right here, there's a water, a body water. So when you're flying at night on the body water, you're not gonna be able to see anything. It will just look pitch black, like it is right here. Look, this is water right here. So that's why you're seeing this. You can even tell the reflection of the water, the light reflecting on the water. So with that little bit of light, it will look totally black. Okay, let's go back this way. Again, this is a body of water right here. That's why it's so dark. So remember, when there's a water, you're not gonna be able to see much. Beautiful, the city lights are beautiful at night. You see that? Contrast, the homes, lighting looks different. I'm gonna let the car pass, then I'm gonna go right behind it here so I don't fly on top of it. 340 feet. This is a restaurant right here. It's a Chinese restaurant. And as you see, when there are no lights, it's really dark. And I'm right here in this parking lot. So I picked this parking lot because it has plenty of lights. See that? This is a dealership right here. They're selling cars. And I believe that's next that gas station. Yep, this is the gas station, right? There's a cell phone tower. I just flew on top of it. The street. This is the storage. So as you see, I'm navigating and I'm staying away from staying on top of cars. If I see like a car like this one, I just avoid it. I can fly on top of, next to the highway. It's not a problem, not on top, but next to, which is totally fine. What I'm gonna do is right now, there's a gas station, I'm gonna turn around. I'm going to switch to manual mode, meaning no GPS flying, just hand fly it. There we go, we're in business. So right now I'm in manual mode. I'll be flying next to the highway. It will make it look like you're flying on top of the highway, but it's not, as you see. I'm going really fast right now. I'm going 52 miles per hour. Okay, there is a car here, so I want to avoid that. It's pretty cool. All right, again. A cell phone tower right here. That's a beautiful. I'm right here where this lighting area is. There's a water tower right here. I'm probably gonna be blocked by the signal. If that happens, I'm gonna... Oh, sorry, this car is really loud here. It's Saturday night and you know how it is. Okay, it's a water tower and this is a high school right here. Okay, I'm gonna be start turning, going back around. There's some cars here, so I'm gonna avoid those and just pass them. I'm going back towards me. Look how beautiful it is flying at night. I love it. All right, so here I am. I am right here. 39% of battery, so I'm just gonna burn a little bit of battery here and call it a day. And I hope that helps you to be more confident to fly night next time. Let's go do some low flying. Oh, nobody's here, so I get to have fun. It's 29% on the battery. So I'm getting up there a little bit. In the dark, and as you see, I'm being light too weak right now. I'm gonna switch to all right. So you see, I'm being light too weak. But now, let's say we lost GPS signal, we did not lose. When you get close to the light area, watch what's gonna happen. The light went away. The warning message. Alrighty, so it's back with the flashing lights right on top. I hope you enjoy the flight. I hope you like the flying part, and thank you for sticking around. I will give you more tips to help you be better, safer pilot. Advantage of flying at night. It's easy to see other air traffic, and also it's calmer wind. So at night, usually the wind is much calmer than the day. The light makes an amazing show, and you experience something that few people have. Speaking of air traffic, special helicopters, if you hear or you see one, descend immediately to lower than treetop or any building in your area. This way will be out of the way. And once you don't hear it anymore, you can go back and climb again. Okay, let's talk about airplane lighting, navigation lighting. So there is a red and there is a green. The red always on the left-hand side, and captain side, driver side. The green always on the right-hand side, passenger side, co-pilot side. So if you're looking at airplane or a helicopter and you see the red is on the right and green is on the left, that means it's coming at you. You need to get out of the way. I'm gonna give you another example. If you're looking at the airplane or helicopter and you see only green light, so the red is hitting in behind. So that means the airplane is coming to your right, coming straight right side. So that's how the way you know if the airplane is coming at you or it's going away from you. It's very important to remember that. Remember, red is on the left, green is on the right. Remember, you're the pilot in command. You're responsible to get out of the way for aircraft. It's called see and avoid. Those are the rules. Okay, survey the area during the day to avoid obstacles and safety hazards. Come during the day and look at the area that you're gonna be flying at night. Look at if there's power lines, anything that you might hit like trees or antennas. My best advice, in fact, come during the day and fly it if you can. That's the best way you can avoid a lot of trouble and a lot of problems. Fly it during the day and familiar yourself with it. Familiar yourself with the area and make sure you understand where you're putting yourself into at night. Flying at night makes it harder to see people, to avoid flying on top of them. Be mindful of that. Practice makes perfect. I suggest that you practice more flying at night so you can build your confidence and be able to fly at night without any problems. Keep learning. Watch other videos and resources to refine your night flying techniques to be safe pilot. I created many videos to help others to be better pilot on my channel. I encourage you to watch them. Subscribe to see more videos like this one, and please don't forget to like and leave a comment down below. Alrighty. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.